it's very nostalgic, you know, to see this beautiful MPH, which in yesteryears had lived its age. And now when we see then and now, is a beautiful journey. She's grown, she's looking beautiful, she's looking majestic. We've seen that transition. How from a raw, depleted building comes a beautiful, magnificent. And she looks so beautiful. Every day she's growing. She's looking prettier. She's looking beautiful. And she's charming everyone. Especially standing from my balcony of the residence and looking at her makes me feel so proud how beautiful this building is going to look. What it looked yesterday and what it looked now. They say with age, you become better. It's like an old wine, which is really going to be tasting better. We look forward for her to come up.
Every time we touched this building when we started off, we were strung by enormous amount of surprises. And the structural engineer told us that it was a miracle and an act of God that this building was still standing. So we are very happy that we've come out of this unscathed and built a world-class infrastructure. Hopefully the next generation of DOSCOs should be there.
A top-class school like ours needs an excellent auditorium, and we didn't have one till now. And over the last 18 months, I have seen this transform from a hangar to an excellent auditorium. And Mr. Harish Suri and his tiny team of professionals has worked tirelessly in spite of COVID-related stoppages and to bring this project to a fruition. And we're very thrilled with the product that we have. We have worked with the best vendors on the land, and while we have spent our money very carefully and wisely, we haven't neglected anything, and we have a modern auditorium which will stand the test of time and will be technologically ready for the future as well. The key challenges were to convert an old existing building into a modern one, and that required a huge amount of buttressing of columns and going into the foundations, etc. We really didn't have any drawings as to what was there. So that, I think, was a key challenge, holding the whole thing up for 18 months and ensuring that the building stands for the next 60 years or more.
As I look back at this journey of 18 months plus, two, three things that are very important. One, how did we manage to build an infrastructure in the middle of three lockdowns and COVID issues that we had during this period? Secondly, I think we are very proud of the fact that we were able to assemble what is certainly the finest team to build an auditorium in India. So we took a lot of care to get the best contractors and give them the freedom to do their work here. And thirdly, I think, which is a work that was done by the architects and by us here in school, was the planning to get all of them to work together to come to a common purpose at the end of it. So to give you an example, while we are finishing the MPH, we have 14 different vendors working simultaneously and 150 people working 12 to 16 hours a day to try and finish this auditorium. So an enormous logistical understanding and work that we have accomplished.
Our first visit to the site was pretty tense, but fortunately for us, the building spoke to us very clearly and told us what it wanted to become. So jointly with the Baxter, we worked on three principles, basic design principles. The first was to enhance the strength of the linear axis and its ceremonial potential. The second was to elevate the cavernous volume of the wall into a soaring cathedral-like space. And lastly, to connect the interior of the building to the absolutely mesmerizing light of room, which in my mind is the intangible essence of the campus. I used to think that you struggle only till you know what to do, and that thereafter it is a matter of detail. But here, the struggle started after we knew how to proceed.
This was a very old structure and the structural drawings were not available. After studying the structure system, it was found that the previous structure was made with brick and RCC composite structure, and we have decided to make the as-built structural drawings, and the structure was also tested by doing destructive and non-destructive testing. After getting the results of non-destructive test, it was found that strength of structure is very weak and it cannot take any further load. We have also studied the new architectural drawings and found that a lot of changes is required in the existing structure, which was not recommended to do in the structure which is not even able to take its own load. We have also studied and seen the 3D views of this new architecture system. After going through the new architecture models and 3D views, we have decided to make this building as conceived by the architect.
If I look back at the project and how it went for approximately 18 months, there were two most challenging aspects. Number one was how to strengthen this building, the old building, how to renew it. And I think the report which we received from the structural engineer to make his ideas into reality, that was the most challenging part for this building. And the second challenging part was restarting the project after the lockdown. That was another challenge. And then the vendors. When you have world-class vendors at one single project, 14, 20 of those vendors working at site at one time, coordinating all of them, taking care of all their requirements and all those things, yes, that was challenging.
And after this completion, you can notice the drastic change in the building. Because earlier, this building was like a mess internally and externally also.
It was a bit raw kind of thing. उसके बाद जैसे जो changes हुए हैं.
There were a lot of differences in the levels also. Now the building, that the movement of the building is smooth. And
earlier it was the foyer area was a gym, used as a gym. तो थोड़ा congested, बहुत ही congested kind of planning थी. उसको हम जो architects ने design किया. उससे फॉयर एरिया का लुक और फील एकदम एनहांस हो गया जो अभी जो डिफरेंस आया.
और जब हम इस बिल्डिंग को देखा तो इस बिल्डिंग को करना ही नामुमकिन था. बहुत ही एकदम बुरी कंडीशन में थी बिल्डिंग और इसमें डर भी लगता था कि ये रिस्की काम है, तो फिर भी हमने हिम्मत करके इसको किया.
Which we got that this place is to be made state of the art auditorium with the best of the systems, meeting all the statutory requirements, keeping in mind the fire and life safety issues, the experience of the users who come to see the to attend any event, and at the same time to retain the character of the place as a multi-purpose hall. Because we were told that the same place is used for conducting the examination also.
It was about the old school way of working that sort of really helped. And Ashish sir's office was really diligent in getting these nuances correct, going into the details, I would say that, looking at the pictures, coming from site and assessing that pictures required a lot of effort. And because of that effort, we were able to do that. And conversion of, an idea into, it required, regular communications with the people who are going to execute. So, luckily, in the initial stages, we were able to, pick and choose the kind of people that we want to work with. And we understood what language they understand. And that sort of helped us to connect with them in the very initial stage of the project. So whatever the detail be, like, you know, the paneling, which was like, I think it's almost like a parametric skin, and it just keeps coming out, it keeps opening at different angles, the size variations happen. So to arrive at that point, we had actually, you know, when we were starting doing that drawing, the idea was there, but when we started doing that, we had a lot of meetings with the contractor itself. The person actually going to do it, the carpenter, we even got him to the office, understood how he is supposed to sort of translate something like this into a reality. And then through regular dialogue, the outcome came and we started sort of putting that across in drawing. And then it became easier for us also to sort of check where the goof up can happen.
चैलेंजेस का कहिएगा तो चैलेंजेस तो बहुत थे, खास करके कोरोना काल में कोरोना नॉब्स के साथ काम करना ही बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है, स्कूल के सारे प्रोटोकॉल के साथ काम करना। सेकेंड थिंग, कोरोना में जब ये लॉकडाउन लगी, लॉकडाउन के बाद डीमोबिलाइजेशन और रीमोबिलाइजेशन, ये एक बहुत बड़ा टास्क था। सारे ट्रांसपोर्ट बंद थे, वर्कर को अपने घर भेजना, फिर दोबारा वापस लेके आना, ये एक बड़ा चैलेंज रहा। सेकेंड थिंग, आर्किटेक्ट मिस्टर सुपर्णा भल्ला जी का जो ड्राइंग थी, जो उनके थॉट्स थे, इसको एज इट इज साकार करना, एज इट इज बनाना, और इस लार्ज स्केल में, ये भी एक चैलेंज रहा। इनके जो डिजाइन थी वो काफ़ी टफ डिजाइन थी, लेकिन हो गया, होप सो आप लोग को पसंद आया।
So why will the interior of this building may be judged, you know, by in a lot of ways? We did keep in mind the safety parameters, understanding the rules for children, understanding that it needs to be here for the near posterity. But I think more importantly, we wanted to see it like a cocoon. A space, a sanctuary, in the middle of these woods, in the middle of these trees, where a lot of different activities could happen, different spaces could become different things. So the flexibility of space and time here was kept in mind, including the fact that we would have a changing light from winter to summer, from day to night. And we wanted it to function completely differently at different points for different events.
अब हमारा प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीशन के स्टेज पे आ चुका है, तो अभी ये जो निकल के आ रहा है, एक ह्यूज और ट्रेमेंडस प्रोजेक्ट के रूप में निकल के आ रहा है। इसकी सबसे बड़ी खूबसूरती ये है कि इसको आप वन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से 360 नहीं देख सकते हैं, इसको आपको पूरा इंटायर देखने के लिए आपको 360 के रोटेट करना पड़ेगा, तब जाके आप इसको पूरा कम्प्लीटली देख पाए।
वो हमारा पैनलिंग है सर, जो वॉल पैनलिंग हमने किया है वो थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट था, इसमें ज़्यादा मेहनत करना पड़ा, और दूसरा हाइट भी ज़्यादा था इसमें, तो इसमें हमें टाइम भी लगा और मेहनत भी लगा, लेकिन मेहनत लगने के बाद अच्छा खुल के आया है, अच्छा लग रहा है।
Hi Doom team, firstly our heartiest congratulations for the proud opening for your project. I'm sure we are all gearing up for it even as we speak. Our personal thanks to the architects who have shortlisted us for this prestigious project. We are very very excited to be working under you for such a prestigious name that you are. We are all striving day and night to ensure that the project gets completed on time. We take this as an opportunity to thank you for giving us the chance to be a part of this dream project. We at Penworkers are all very very excited. We assure you of our full service and cooperation, not only now during the course of installation, but even afterwards in case there is any maintenance issue or anything. Our heartiest congratulations once again. It's been a long and a very tedious journey for you, but I'm sure in the end you'll be standing tall. Mr. Kalsi has been actively involved already with you for the project installation, and he will again be on site as and when required. Augustine has already been in touch with you and your team regarding the initial sales follow-up, the drawings, etc., blah, blah, blah. So, very, very excited. Look forward to working with you again for another project, and all the best always. Thank you so much.
To name a few, in the audiovisual system, we have used Tannoy speakers, which is one of the oldest in the industry, and we have used Atlona microphones, which is a preferred brand for in most of the Hollywood and Bollywood studios. And we have a webcasting device which has got cameras, and all the programs can be recorded and uploaded and streamed live through the website or any cloud. And apart from that, we have digital amplifiers, network-based amplifiers and digital signal processors. Any system integrator can attend the problem by sitting in the remote corner by logging onto the system. And we also have the screen and projector. Projector being from the Christie with motorized zoom lens. The same projector can be used for multiple screen sizes.
So there are a lot of aspects to this building that appear like advancements, you know, like the structure itself, those kind of spaces we created. But it's the achievements that really need talking about. Today this building is compliant by the National Building Code. The structure is compliant. It's earthquake resilient. It follows all fire codes and norms. Evacuation procedures in this building can be maintained as per any building of global standards. It has the most amazing acoustic and audiovisual sort of equipment that can be used and even operated by the students themselves. Retractable seating allows the floor of the MPH to clear up for sports, games, or even examination activities. And it is compliant even for those who are physically challenged, or who are unable to, you know, access spaces, which typically is the case with a lot of buildings in a lot of campuses. But this building is completely compliant. It has ramps. It has also got a hydraulic lift or a platform to elevate somebody to the even to the level of the stage. It's the most interestingly, this building has even managed to achieve, and I say, I don't use the word lightly, I say the word in great seriousness, has managed to achieve global standards. A building that started off as actually in the negative is now in the serious positive of all kinds of global standards, whether it's our seating, our ability to move around the spaces, the green rooms, the back areas, the services, the HVAC systems, even the lighting. It has two or three types of lighting for two or three types of activities. Everything has been planned into its veins. It's definitely a great achievement.
अब हमारा ये प्रोजेक्ट फिनिशिंग होने वाला है और हमारे को ये बहुत अच्छा लगा है, डिज़ाइनिंग करा बहुत अच्छा, मतलब अलग अलग ही ऑडिटोरियम बनना है, बहुत अच्छा लगा, हम बहुत खुश हैं, मतलब हमारे को यहाँ मौका मिला काम करने का आप लोगों के साथ और अच्छा लग रहा, बहुत अच्छा।
जब ये बिल्डिंग बन रही है, जैसे खली से फूल खिलता है पर अपने पूरी जवानी पे आता है, उस टाइप से ये चल रहा है और ये आगे बहुत खूबसूरत बिल्डिंग है।
It's very, very heartening and amazing to see a little baby being born. I think the size of the auditorium is going to shock everybody, you know. And once we put the audiovisual systems and all the related infrastructure, we are quite sure that this will be one of the finest auditoriums that exist in the country. As I said, we leave this behind as for posterity of the next generation of DOSCOs to enjoy an auditorium of world-class standards.
Well, the expression is, it's joyous, abundance of joyous and gratefulness to everybody who's helped this project to finally see it come into shape, because we had to face, like I mentioned earlier, so many lockdowns, so many stoppages, you know. Gratitude to one and everyone, thanks to the entire team, thanks to the board, thanks to the board for standing by the team and, you know, letting us, giving us that freedom to come out with a thing of this magnitude. I'm sure it's the best in this country and comparable to any best in this country.
Seeing this project go from a hangar to a modern auditorium has been absolutely thrilling. We have watched it stage by stage, and today I had a demonstration of the lights and the acoustics and the HVAC, and it has been absolutely stunning, the transformation. We are completely thrilled by every aspect of this, whether it's the seating or the acoustics or the lights or the stagecraft or the audiovisual equipment that we have there. We are completely thrilled by the results we have achieved.
There was this amazing poetic image that was sent to me from Saipa, in fact, which had these shafts of light that finally came in through the window slits that we left. There was a lot of debate that went into all aspects of this, but everybody who was on this, because it's a huge collaborative exercise, agreed on the valuable nature of preserving the light. I mean, it's no, it's no surprise that even the symbol for Doom School is the light. So I think the idea of light and enlightenment, it's very connected in the concept that we try to produce here. Needless to say, hours and hours and day, man days and man nights of work, and some woman nights also. But it was something that, you know, was about daring to dream and then getting everybody together to get them to believe in this dream. And then it was almost like we all worked in conjunct with each other. It was actually quite amazing. It was a time of great sadness and great ugliness, I would say. And here is this building that is being built through this ugly time. A beautiful building. It gives so much hope that we are capable of so much beauty even in a time which is ugly. So I think that was a supremely amazing lesson, learning, whatever you want to say. Thanking everybody seems a little trivial because there were so many people, and even if we begin with, you know, especially the headmaster who was extremely lent a huge ear, and he actually just believed in what was coming up. We couldn't have done it without the support of his entire team, the administration, even all the team that handled the labor. Mr. Suri was pivotal, needless, like I said, to say. And, Arun was there like a rock. So, I mean, this is besides all those consultants that, and the numerous consultations and headaches that we gave them. And most of all, everybody who worked in all these offices, you know, we tend to think that it's, the building was built by one person or even designed by one. It's not true, actually. There are thousands of hands. And last but not the least, I think I have to personally thank Ashish Chaudhary for being co-conspirator and collaborator. Conspirator, thank you. In this entire journey, he made me and the firm see different points and perspectives that actually widened the horizon of this building.
I refer to this MPH building, which we now call auditorium, as she. I know in all boys' school, calling a building she, because to her name adds a lot of this beautiful look of hers. Yes, she is majestic. And when I say she, I see a little girl born, groomed up into a beautiful child, and now becoming a smart lady. She walks tall, she stands tall. Amongst all the boys who eye on her and want to be with her, want to be in her, and this is what is so beautiful. I call it She. because she's symbolic of beauty. She's symbolic of ultimate magnificence, and that's what she's proud of. And that's the proud lady of the Queen's Gate.
पहले पुराना था सर, अब हमने बनाया इसको तोड़ फोड़ कर मेहनत करके और बढ़िया बना, देखने में खूबसूरती हुआ। आप पहले घुटन में था, अब बढ़िया हुआ है।